I'm going to go back to the federal courthouse outside Greensboro. John Edwards making a statement. Let's listen in.
The attention they paid to the evidence during the trial, the presentations of the lawyers, and the fact that they've now spent almost nine full days deliberating, trying to reach a fair and just result under the evidence and the law. And all I can say is thank goodness we live in a country that has the kind of system that we have. And I think those jurors were an exemplar for what juries are supposed to do in this country. They were very, very impressive. The second thing I want to say just a word about is responsibility. And this is about me. I want to make sure that everyone hears from me and from my voice that while I do not believe I did anything illegal or ever thought I was doing anything illegal, I did an awful, awful lot that was wrong. And there is no one else responsible for my sins. None of the people who came to court and testified are responsible. Nobody working for the government is responsible. I am responsible. And if I want to find the person who should be held accountable for my sins, honestly, I don't have to go any further than the mirror. It's me. It is me and me alone. Next thing I want to say a word about are the people that I love, because it's been an incredible experience for me to watch my parents. My dad just turned 80. My mom, who's 78, tromp up here from Robbins, North Carolina every day to be with me and to support me. And I love them so much, and they did such a wonderful job raising me and my brother, Blake, and my sister, Kathy, who I also love dearly. I also want to say a word about my own children. Kate, who most all of you have seen, has been here every single day. She has been here no matter what, no matter how awful and painful a lot of the evidence was for her. Evidence about her dad, evidence about her mom, who she loves so, so dearly. But she never once flinched. She said, "Dad, I love you. I'll be there for you no matter what." And I'm so proud to have had her with me through all this process. And then finally, Emma, who turned 14 recently, Emma Claire and Jack, who just turned 12, who I take care of every day. And I've not been able to see them quite as much, but I see them in the morning. I get their breakfast ready, get them off to school, and then we get home at night and we all eat supper together. And I love them both so dearly, and they're such an important part of every day of my life. And then finally, my precious Quinn. Who I love more than any of you could ever imagine. And I am so close to and so, so grateful for. So grateful for Quinn. I'm grateful for all my children, including my son, Wade, who we lost years ago. But you know, this is the last thing I'm going to say. I don't think God's through with me. I really believe He thinks there's still some good things I can do. And whatever happens with this legal stuff going forward, what I'm hopeful about is all those kids that I've seen, you know, in the poorest parts of this country and in some of the poorest places in the world, that I can help them in whatever way I'm still capable of helping them. And I want to dedicate my life to being the best dad I can be and to helping those kids who I think deserve help and who I hope I can help. Thank you all very much.